What looked like any other Capitol Hill press conference quickly sounded different. Two senators from two parties publicly on the same page.
We have an agreement on an amendment to prevent criminals and the mentally ill and insane from getting firearms and harming people.
The common ground rests on a simple proposition, and that is that criminals and the dangerously mentally ill shouldn't have guns.
Right now, background checks are required only on sales by licensed firearm dealers. The deal would expand checks to include gun shows and internet sales. It comes from senators who are both rated as strong gun rights supporters by the NRA, though the NRA quickly released a statement saying background checks at gun shows won't fix a broken mental health system. It continues, the sad truth is no background check would have prevented the tragedies in Newtown, Aurora, or Tucson. The Newtown shootings are a large part of this debate. President Obama went to Connecticut this week to urge Congress to act. And on the Senate floor, Democrat Christopher Murphy used photos of the victims to call for a gun control vote.
What kind of liberty did these kids have in that classroom in Newtown, being trapped by an assault weapon-wielding madman?
At least 14 Republican senators have pledged to filibuster if the Senate will open debate on new gun laws. That could happen as soon as Thursday. And it would take 60 votes to overcome the filibuster. The background check compromise may help secure those votes, but it's still unclear if there's enough support for any gun control bills to become actual laws. In Washington, I'm Emily Schmidt.